Hey guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel. It is 11 in the morning and I am just having my coffee. So cheers for that. So today there's no makeup tutorial. Today I want to sit down and tell you guys the three essential makeup steps that you need to know in order to create a flawless makeup, or simply if you want to perfect and get better at makeup. So today I'm going to talk about those three essential steps that you need to know, and I have my notes right here so that way I don't forget anything. So before we get started, if you guys haven't subscribed to my channel, go ahead and subscribe, and also don't forget to hit that bell notification so that way you guys get notified whenever I post a video. And without any further ado, let's go ahead and get started. So last night I wrote down all the ideas that I had in mind. Okay guys, I'm just gonna go ahead and talk. If you guys hear a noise, that's like the bathroom, because my room is close to the bathroom, so I'm so sorry about that. I really wanted to narrow three steps so that way you don't forget the steps, and also I don't want you to remember 10 or 7 or 12 or 20 steps. I just narrowed it down to three steps so that way you guys don't forget, and those three steps are really essential. So the first step that you really need to know and apply in order to step up your makeup game, and this is very good if you are a makeup beginner, have the necessary tools. So I want you to think of this as if you were creating a cake, right? You want to have all of your tools so that way you make a delicious and yummy cake. So that is the same thing for makeup. In order to create a flawless makeup, you need your tools. So with this step, I'm gonna go ahead and tell you examples. I'm not a chef, I'm not a bakery girl, I don't bake anything, but I know that in order to create that cake, you need to have the base, your spoons, your cup ingredients, and all of that stuff. So having that in mind, having that cake in mind, is the same thing with your face. So within that first step, have the necessary tools, I put down brushes. It is essential to have the right amount of brushes when you are starting a makeup. And I'm going to go back in time when I was a makeup beginner. I didn't have all of my tools, I didn't have my brushes, but now I figure that I have enough tools, like I have my brushes and everything. You don't really need to buy a bunch of brushes when you are a beginner. So I'm going to show you the important brushes that you need to have in your makeup kit. You don't really need to spend a lot of money to buy a bunch of brushes when you are starting your makeup. So you need at least two fluffy brushes. And the reason why is because you want to have a blending fluffy brush to blend out like your natural transition shade. And you want to have another extra one just for backup. And also you need at least two small brushes. These two small brushes will help you like blend out your shades if you want to be more detailed and more precise. At least two brushes would be good for that. And then you also need at least two concealer brushes. So this one is from e.l.f. and this one is from Artistry. So you wanna have two concealer brush just in case, one for backup and one for you to use. And I also want you guys to have at least one flat eyeliner brush. And this is good if you want to like go underneath your eyes and blend out that shade. And also you want to have a brow brush. So you want to have one that has like a spoolie and also the brush itself. So you need this to basically define your brows. So this is really essential for your makeup toolkit as well. And then we're gonna go ahead and talk about the big brushes. So I want you guys to have this flat foundation brush. This flat foundation brush is good if you are not a sponge person. So this flat foundation brush is gonna help you blend out your foundation. You want to find one that is like this, flat on the top. And also I want you guys to have at least two blush brush, and one is to obviously apply your blush, and the other one I personally use it to if I apply like a setting powder, I use this blush brush to basically remove my powder. And I like how it is super fluffy, so I personally have two. That's all I have, so that's why I recommend that you guys have at least two. And I also want you guys to have a contour brush. You will need to contour and bronze your face. So I really like this one because it's like an angled brush. So if you want to apply like a contour or bronzer, this is really good for you to like go and tap your bronzer. So you guys go in Target when this whole dynamic is over, make sure to grab your contour brush and all of the brushes that I mentioned. And also, last but not least, I want you guys to have a highlighter brush. So this is like a fan brush. So this will basically grab your highlighter and you could apply it right here and make it look so cute and so flawless. So I really recommend this brush as well. So if you are really taking this makeup game very seriously, then these are all the brushes that I recommend for you, and this is how much you will need. And also, another important tool that you need is your sponge. This baby is from e.l.f. It's very cheap. It was like $5 or $6. And the reason why you want to have a sponge is because whenever you are setting your face, you want to grab your setting powder and basically go underneath your eyes and set your face. You can also use this baby to apply your foundation and to even blend your contour. Okay guys, so now we're gonna go ahead and move on to the other essential tool that you need. So for your makeup base, you need your foundation, you need your concealer, you need your setting spray, you need your setting powder, you need your bronzer, you need your primer, you need your moisturizer, and you need your highlighter. I know it's overwhelming, I know it seems a lot, but trust me guys, you need those things. You really need that tool to create a flawless makeup base, because when I was a beginner, I never thought of using a setting powder, a setting spray, and when I didn't apply my setting powder or I didn't apply my setting spray, my makeup didn't last long. So that is why you guys need those, because we're talking about stepping up our makeup game, stepping up and getting like out of our comfort zone and just basically going for it. So I am giving you this essential tool so that way you guys know which tools you actually need and which tools you don't need. So for example, you don't really need to contour. Some people like to only bronze their face. Some people like to contour and bronze. I personally just used to bronze my face, but I recently started to contour my face. So that is one thing that I'm just giving you guys options to choose. Either you want to contour or don't want to contour your face. That's the only thing I'm giving you guys options to choose. Then we're gonna go ahead and move on to the eye products. So for the eyes, we need a palette. So if you are a makeup beginner and you don't know where to go, I recommend you guys get a natural eyeshadow palette, so that way you start like smooth. A natural eyeshadow palette will enable you to basically play around with your eyeshadows. So the palette that I'm going to show you, I think you guys have seen it, it's this baby right here. This is the Morphe 350 Natural Glow, and I have this baby for more than 7 months now, and this baby has been my go-to. I bought this baby when I first started my YouTube channel, and I still have it, I still use it. There is a lot of natural eyeshadow palettes out there, so choose the one that you want, that you like, and basically go for it. But if you guys don't know which one, then I recommend this for you because it is very natural. You have your oranges, you have your brows, and you have your transition color, so it's a win-win. And also, it's not that expensive. So go to morphe.com and get you this palette if you haven't. And then the other thing that you need is your brow pomade. So having a brow pomade or a pencil, this is up to you. Either you want a pencil or a pomade. I personally use the pomade brow. So get you guys some brow pomade or pencil, because you actually need to sculpt your brows and make it cute. And then this other tool is another option that I'm giving to you guys. You don't really need to. The other tool is lashes. When I first started my YouTube channel, I will wear the Ardell lashes. the Kiss lashes, and those lashes were super natural and I really love them because they were easy to apply. So if you are a beginner and you still struggle to apply your lashes, the Ardell lashes and the Kiss lashes is great because it is very easy to apply and it's not that expensive as well. So if you messed up, it's not like you're wasting like a $20 or $30 on lashes. So I really recommend that if you're a beginner. But even though if you're a makeup beginner and you really want to go for it, then I recommend the Lurella lashes. I also recommend the Batty Bee lashes. I also recommend the Lily lashes. And yeah, that's it. Those are the only three lashes that I have used and they work perfectly. And the one that I'm using right now is from Lurella Cosmetics. And these lashes are like in the medium price. They're like $10 compared to the Batty Bee, which is like 20 something. And then the Lily lashes, which is like $30. Okay guys, so the next thing is your lips. You just need to have a lip liner and a lipstick or a liquid lipstick, whichever you prefer. So if you guys have been watching me, I really love me a new lipstick. And so I have like a bunch of new lip liners. So this one that I use today is from Slick Makeup. And this baby is very nice because it's like a brow natural lip liner. And so this one helps me define my lips. And then I go for the lipstick. My favorite one is from Morphe, which is the shade Bare All. I really recommend this one because it's like very nude. It's like pinkish nude. And I like to use this one just to like brighten up the center of my lips. So I really recommend this lipstick. So yeah guys, that is all for step one. That is all the tools that I mentioned that it is essential to have. Okay guys, so moving to step number two. The step number two is to make sure your makeup base is on point. So now that you have all your tools, right? You want to use those tools in order to create your makeup base. So having those tools, you will now go ahead and create your makeup base. So in order to create your makeup base, you need your foundation. So I already did a makeup base tutorial where I just focus on how you apply your makeup base. So if you guys are interested, I'm going to leave the link in the description down below so that way you guys go ahead and check it out after you finish watching this video. So let's go back in time when I was a makeup beginner. I would think that it wasn't necessary to apply your concealer, your setting powder. So the only thing I would do is apply my foundation, apply some bronzer, and basically that was it. That's literally all I did. But then when I would go outside and see like all the girls with their makeup looking flawless and on point, on fleek, I looked at myself and I'm like, so I told myself that I need to step up my makeup game because I want to look very flawless. So I went on YouTube, watched a lot of makeup tutorials, and that's how I basically learned. So in order for your cake to come out really nice, you want your baking to be on point. Because if you miss like 5 minutes or even 1 minute baking your cake, it's going to come out a little bit weird. It's not going to come out perfect. So the same thing with the face, you want to basically apply all the steps to create that flawless base. And within that, I'm gonna go to step number three. And the last step is practice, guys. Practice is key. So now that you have all your makeup ingredients, all your makeup products, you need to use those makeup products to practice on your face. You want to learn how to do your makeup base. You want to learn how to apply your eyeshadows. And I've created some eyeshadow tutorials if you guys want to go and check them out. So you want to basically practice. So if you're not good at something, if you're not good on adding your eyeshadows, if you're not good on applying your eyelashes, if you want to perfect your eyebrows, your lips, you need to practice and basically watch a lot of YouTube videos, because that honestly helped me a lot to basically step up my makeup game. Because before I would do my makeup, but I knew that I needed to practice in order to get better. And we honestly can't argue about that step, because basically you apply that into your daily life. Practice is key, being consistent, and Yeah, so I really recommend you guys to practice and basically get the gist of it. Don't be afraid to go out of your comfort zone. Don't be afraid if you like colors. Don't be afraid to add colors. If it comes out bad, at least you try, you know? Because the more you practice, the better you are going to get. And that's just simply how it is in everyday life. Like, if you practice something, you want to do something, and you practice, you will get better. So the same thing with makeup. I really encourage you guys to practice, and I really encourage you guys to get your tools, because honestly, when I first started my makeup, there's certain tools that I didn't have. And so slowly but surely, I started like buying my brushes. I started like, you know, investigating which foundation fits me well and blah blah blah. So yeah guys, that is all the steps that you need to remember and you need to know in order to step up your makeup game. And this is very good for you makeup beginners. And yeah guys, if you guys made it to the end, thank you so much. I hope this 3 steps will really help you get an idea of how to start your makeup journey. And if there is a specific tutorial or a review that you guys want me to do, leave a comment down below so that way I know which tutorial you guys want to see. And yeah guys, that is it for this video. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you guys in my next video.